first things first, I was surprised by the vote and by the size of it passing, which inevitably means that there's bipartisan support for this bill. Why do you think that is, Royce?
Because the essence of this bill is about ensuring everyone is deemed innocent until proven guilty, or at least trying to honor that aspect of our Constitution. We are all deemed innocent until proven guilty. And then as a society, I think we have to really question the true social value of mugshots. This isn't about trying to do anything to protect criminals. This isn't about trying to do anything to make law enforcement's job harder. But it is about recognizing that we live in a digital world and images get shared easily, so that if you or I or one of our family members are wrongfully arrested, or if we are arrested and we're ultimately not convicted, the fact of the matter is that there are a number of cases that never lead to conviction, a number of arrests that never lead to conviction, but 100% of arrests have mugshots. So people's reputations are on the line, people standing in the community are on the line. Oftentimes when there could be a situation where someone was wrongfully accused, or it could be a mistaken identity. So that's what this is really about. This is definitely a bipartisan issue. This is not a partisan issue. Other states have passed this legislation and it's been led by conservatives. So people see beyond the party piece here. It's really about everyone's right to be presumed innocent until proven guilty. And we know that mugshots are prejudicial.
Okay, so we understand that they won't be, that the bill stipulates that they're not shared publicly in terms of the media or anything like that. But if in fact someone is arrested in the booking part of the Orleans Parish website or Jefferson Parish Sheriff's Office, if you searched a particular person, their mugshot does come up there. Does this bill address that as well, to taking it completely out of the sheriff's office or anything like that, that this is not shared publicly at all?
Yeah, the sheriff's office will still be able to have the photo to conduct their investigations. It just would no longer be in the public record unless the person is a fugitive, or unless a local police department or sheriff's department deems the person to be an imminent danger to the community. Upon those grounds, they can release the photograph. Also, they can petition a court to release the photo for any justifiable reason that the court determines is in the public interest for the photo to be released. So there are exceptions for the photos to be released. They won't be accessible on the websites like they currently are.
Got it. In the case of, let's say, a gentleman who has committed a carjacking, and we suspect this guy also carjacked other people, because we found this, that, and the other, they would have to petition the court. We'd like to petition the court to be able to share this photo. And if the court deems it necessary, then something like that could happen, is what you're saying.
Correct. So it's not a complete ban. And I think people see the legislation headlines and don't understand some of the exceptions that we have in the bill. And they think it's a complete ban. What it's aimed at doing is adding more protections for people on the pre-conviction side. But there are exceptions to keep the community safe.
I work in a business where, in fact, to me, even on this side, it has felt, in a sense, prejudicial. Certainly, in some cases, I think prejudicial to a certain particular group of individuals, particular group of individuals who look like me, certainly. Did you take any of that into consideration? Because obviously other folks, you know what I'm saying, may not have, but totally. did it dawn on you in that respect that, hey, for Black men in this community or across America, these mugshots have been shown to do A, B, C, and D?
Oh, there's no question about it that mugshots certainly help to reinforce a stereotype amongst Black males around criminality and a criminal persona. So there's no question that mugshots certainly reinforce those stereotypes. And newspapers across the country, not all, but many newspapers across the country have already taken the voluntary step to be more discretionary about mugshots that they actually publish. because they recognize the harm of publishing a mugshot, that it definitely reinforces a negative stereotype, particularly for people of color, Black men in particular. But I have kept most of this focus around the simple fact that we are all entitled to be deemed innocent until proven guilty. And there's no question that a mugshot has the effect of making someone look guilty.
Yeah, and if in fact you're found innocent, there's no recourse.
There's no recourse.
Yeah, and even if in fact a newspaper or a television station or whatever decides to report that, you know, Royce Duplessis was found innocent.
My photo's still out there. And it's a photo that's taken on the worst day of your life.
Yeah.
And again, you have to question, what public value does it serve? If it's a safety matter, if the person's a fugitive or if they're an imminent threat, the photo can still be released. So law enforcement still has that discretion, which is why law enforcement has not publicly opposed the bill. Seeing these shifts, and we've seen that this is something that needs to happen. But law enforcement will still be able to do what they need to do in those type of circumstances. They can release photos for someone who they deem to be an imminent threat to the community, or even petition the court if necessary. If a family member or someone is missing and they think there's a photograph that's being held by a local sheriff, they can petition the court to have that photo released.
As it relates to this now moving to the Senate, what do you envision there? Do you see a tough challenge there, or Royce, where do you see this?
Yeah, I still think we are in for a lot of debate on this bill. I know that it still makes some people uncomfortable. Especially the fact that now it's moved out of the House. I think that those who may be opposed to that bill might double down on their efforts to try to oppose it, but we're just going to keep having the conversation. And it's really just about educating folks. I had a lot of people who told me they were initially opposed to the legislation, but after I explained to them what the intent of it is and ultimately what the bill does, they ended up supporting the bill. I also had a lot of people who told me they supported the bill who, in that number, who voted against it, they just voted against it because someone back home didn't like it, but they supported the bill. So we're working through that. And I think ultimately we're going to get to the finish line. I don't know if there's going to be any amendments to the bill, but right now we'll just take it one day at a time. So there's still going to be some opposition and some skepticism, but it's all about just trying to have the conversation.
You drove the bus in the House. Is there a counterpart on the Senate side that drives the bus in the Senate for this, or are you able to speak to the Senate with regards to
this? I'm going to present it in committee whenever it's scheduled. I don't know when that's going to be yet, but I'm going to present the bill to the committee. But on the Senate floor, someone is going to have to carry it for me, and I don't know yet who that person is going to be.